somebody may wondering, you know, how this whole thing really works. Yeah, if I have to work my development, how do I get started? What is my starting point and what is my ending point? How do I come to know what should I do on the day one? Should I do a requirement prioritization, or how do I create my ways of working? So there are 5-step process which I'm introducing so that you get a sufficient understanding about the discipline agile content outline. So what they tell is that the whole objective is choose your ways of working. Yeah, that's the whole thing. Ultimately, I personally believe whichever framework you use, you are the owner of your ways of working, and you need to own it. And the sooner you do, the better it is. Don't blame XXX framework or a methodology or a toolkit if something is not working, because those were very standard things. They were made for a given context and they may not work as it is in your context. The sooner you own it, the things will start working. So what is the approach which DA is talking about? It is telling, first, before you even pick up a process, yeah, don't say we will do Scrum. Don't say we will do Kanban, or don't say we will do Waterfall. Well, you need to decide based on your context. Look at, do I have a dynamic requirement, or I have a stable requirement, or whatever, that there could be some parameters which you can use to understand what problem I am solving, in which area I am operating in. So there has to be an evaluation of your context. Now, how to do it? There are some tools which can help you in doing it, and I will introduce one of them in the rest of the content. Now, once you understand your context, then you select the best fit life cycle. So the idea here is, there could be one life cycle which may look like a Scrum. There could be another life cycle which may look like a Kanban. There could be another life cycle which might be needing project way of working, where you have project charter, initial level of funding, milestones, and governance process in place. It's very difficult to say for an organization that this organization will always do a continuous delivery, or this organization will always do a project. There could be the areas where project way of working might be needed. There might be areas where the continuous delivery way of working might be needed. So once you analyze your context, and it might be very difficult to assume that organization operate in just one context. There are organizations, there are support teams which are taking care of existing products. There are teams which are creating new innovative product. They don't even know will this product will succeed or not. And there are teams which are creating a next version of an existing successful product. Now, we cannot replicate one team's process to another team because they are working in a different context. So analyze the context, and based on that, select the best fit life cycle. So Discipline Agile gives you 6 choices. We'll talk about them. So it's like you are selecting your bigger frame. So you need to stitch your ways of working, but the stitching of ways of working may require the outer layer to get ready first. And by selecting the life cycle, you are creating that outer framework, frame for your work. And then you get deeper and connect the dot, the third process which they are talking about. So there could be various process goals. Yeah, in some places, you may need to hire the developers and create a new team. In some contexts, you don't need that. So you don't have a process goal of bringing, forming the team. Team is already formed. So depending upon where you fit, even your context is well understood, we try to understand that, okay, in this delivery space, we have X number of goals. Which are the goals are more relevant for us based on our context and selection of life cycle? We identify the process goals. So process goal can be understood like forming a team, creating a shared vision for the product. It's a process goal. Coordinating activities with each other is a process goal. So this out of these, we have a list of those process goals. So the team come together and they need to find out which are the process goals are relevant for us. That's a step 3. Now, when we go into deeper, we understood the process goals, assuming coordinating activities with each other is a process goal. Now, how to do it? We need to make some choices. Now, you can do a daily 15 minutes meeting, or you can do with the help of a digital dashboard also. If you have a situation where your team members are spread across multiple geographies and multiple time zones, you may prefer not to have a 15 minutes meeting. You don't want everybody to come together. You want them to look at a digital space, and that is how they probably will operate. Now, the another team which is working in the more or less in the same time zone may use a 15 minutes meeting to coordinate their work. And that is how we are making the choices. So it is not a one choice which is applied to all the teams. Even if their life cycle is same, but depending upon their context, they can have different way of achieving how do we coordinate activities with each other. And that's the fourth step. And when we have the fourth step, you have your ways of working ready. So you have a life cycle. You understand which of the process goals are important, and you know how are you going to achieve those process goals. And then continuously improvement. So the whole idea is, be it a discipline or a XYZ framework, even in the waterfall world, there was always a need of continuous improvement. And we may just pick up the waterfall methodology as defined in our organization templates, not in a book. Yeah. And we just follow it and never look for inspecting and adapting and continuously improving it. And then we blame the waterfall. Then it might be not the right idea to do. So any framework, it is a good starting point. And here the difference they are telling is, we are doing guided continuous improvement. So it's like this: when you are looking for improvement, again, you may relook at all the processes which are available to you, because the knowledge base is giving you collection of processes. You don't have to reinvent your own process all the time. Sometimes you may want to reinvent that, but majority of the cases, you may find something which you can use from the Discipline Agile toolkit space itself.